Hi, I'm Dr. Lyle Victor. I'm a Beaumont physician specializing in sleep medicine. Today we're going to talk about sleepy people who snore. If you're tired and sleepy and you snore, you almost for sure have sleep apnea. Call Beaumont Health today and see one of our providers and get a sleep test. We can probably do the test right in your home. When you fall asleep, your tongue is relaxed and flops against the back of your throat. That causes snoring. And it turns out that the heavier you are, the larger your tongue is. So when the tongue is back, you're going to snore, and that snoring causes you to wake up just a little bit. Not enough to get out of bed, but enough that you feel lousy and tired the next day. Here's a picture of a normal and a sleep apnea airway. Notice that the normal airway is actually fairly large, but when you gain weight and the tongue gets bigger, and by the way, the side of the throat gets bigger as well, there's not much room back there. You're going to snore, you're going to arouse at night, you're going to gasp. But a third of our patients have small jaws, or they have a receding jaw. Some of these patients don't snore loudly, but they do make noise at night. So the sleep apnea patient may snore like this. And someone with a small jaw may just tug a little bit. Snoring or tugging, you're going to arouse at night and feel tired during the day. There are three treatments for sleep apnea: CPAP, or continuous positive airway pressure, or a dental appliance, and then there's surgery. Let's talk about CPAP first, because it's been around the longest and we have the best science behind it. Here's what the CPAP mask looks like. It just fits over your nose, and then there's gentle air that's pushed into your nose, in your throat, and keeps your throat open. The CPAP will get rid of your snoring, and you probably can move back into the bedroom if you've been kicked out for all the loud noises you're making. The gentle air is pumped into your nose and keeps your throat open. Think of a car going about 10 miles an hour. Put your head out the window and open your mouth, and that's what CPAP feels like. Most people tolerate CPAP very well. You do need to have an open nose to tolerate the mask well. But some of our patients will have nasal disease. In my experience, nasal disease can cause problems with CPAP. You need to have an open nose. Let me show you what that's like. If your nose is obstructed, one side or the other, you may need to have an ears, nose, and throat evaluation. Ask your Beaumont provider. For some people who can't wear the mask or don't want to wear the mask, you may qualify for a dental appliance, which is made by your dentist. The dental appliance is two plates, and the bottom plate moves forward and pulls the tongue off the airway. There are two kinds of surgery. One is a jaw surgery, often done on younger patients that may have a bite problem. And then there is the Inspire procedure, which is a small probe that fits in the base of the tongue and causes the tongue to go forward when you take a breath during sleep. You will need a sleep study to get treated for sleep apnea. If you're feeling tired and you snore, call a Beaumont Sleep Center near you and we'll get you a test. For more information on sleep medicine services at Beaumont, visit beaumont.org/sleep.